Have you ever worn your heart on your sleeve? What about in your hair? My friends Yuri and Joel developed the Pulse Sensor. It's an open source heart rate sensor that's easy to plug into any Arduino project, including this heart-shaped LED display. Today I'll show you how to make your own beating heart headband. I made this project with Jimmy Rogers for Make Volume 29, and you can find all of the instructions on makeprojects.com. We're using parts from the Mintduino tin to make our own breadboard Arduino clone. You'll also need the open heart display kit and the pulse sensor, all of which you can pick up in the maker shed. To power the project, I'm using a tiny lithium polymer battery managed by the LilyPad power board. For the crafty part of the project, you'll need some cord elastic, a needle and thread or sewing machine, and some brocade ribbon like these I got at Britex Fabrics in San Francisco. To make the headband, measure the circumference of your head where the headband will sit, and cut two lengths of ribbon that length. I'm using this red grosgrain ribbon as a backing. Cut a 6-inch piece of cord elastic and tie it into a loop, or substitute a sturdy hair tie. Line up the ribbons and use a zigzag stitch to tack them together, but only at the ends. Leave the middle section open to incorporate the electronics. Next, form the circle of the headband by folding and pinning the raw ends around the loop of elastic and stitching them in place. Assemble the open heart display according to the instructions on Jimmy's website and prototype your circuit on a solderless breadboard. If you've never done that before, check out the great guide that goes with the Mintduino on makeprojects.com. Upload your Arduino code and test to see that your circuit's working. Then set up your perf board by dry fitting the components and marking their locations. Check out this handy diagram where we've done some of that work for you. Trim the board to fit behind the open heart and file the edges to be smooth. Repopulate the circuit board and solder the components according to the diagram. Wire up the sensor and power board and lay the circuit out on your headband to decide where the display will go. When you find the spot you like, pierce those header pins through the outer layer of ribbon and make a circuit sandwich with the Arduino clone on the other side. Solder up those header pins to connect them to the logic circuit. Now it's time to secure all the components inside the headband. Stitch the power board in place, leaving a space for the tiny battery, and keep in mind that your on-off switch is also on this board, so you'll probably want to reach it. Run the sensor out a small opening in the back of the headband so it can loop around to clip to your ear. Stitch down the wires so they stay put. I usually do this by hand. Use a zigzag stitch to sew the headband shut along the remaining edges. You may have to hand stitch some tight spots near the circuit board. I use snaps to make a reclosable opening so I can show off the circuit and in case I need to make any repairs. I like this headband so much, I made a few more without the electronics just so I could wear it more often. And the pulse sensor is great for any Arduino heart rate project, and it can clip onto your finger as well as your earlobe. Perfect for earmuffs, knitted caps and gloves, and headphones. What would you build? Leave me a note in the comments below. Check out these other Technology Craft episodes and subscribe for more videos from Craft.